Lot 52 in our auction is called Death of Procris and dates to 1929. It's by Mainey Jellett, who is one of the most important female artists in Ireland and also one of the most important artists in terms of the history of modern art in Ireland. The painting comes to us from the family of James White, former director of the National Gallery of Ireland. He was director there from 1964 to 1980, and he acquired the work directly from the artist. Since it was executed in 1929, it formed part of major exhibitions, which Jellett included it in, both in Ireland and abroad, major solo exhibitions and group shows. And then later, after the artist's death, it formed part of important retrospective exhibitions that celebrated the importance of Jellett's work, both in 1962 and in 1992. So a very, very important canvas we have here, a very large example by her. Mainey Jellett was born not far from our offices here on Molesworth Street. She was born in 36 Fitzwilliam Square in Dublin, and she was schooled at the Metropolitan here in Dublin and came under the influence of Orpin. She later travelled to the Westminster School of Art, which was run at the time by Walter Sickert. And both these schools formed the basis of her training and her understanding and appreciation for figure and form. But it wasn't until she travelled to Paris that she really came into her own and was exposed to important trends that were happening there, Paris being the artistic centre, the artistic hub of movements, artistic movements at the time. She was exposed to analytical cubism, whose chief exponents were Picasso and Braque, and also to movements such as Orphism that really celebrated and introduced very bright colours into abstraction. So all these trends were happening around Mainey Jellett while she was in Paris, and all of them, I suppose, informed her style. But the theories that she gravitated most towards were those of Albert Gleize, who developed the technique or the theory of rotation and translation. And Procris, The Death of Procris, 1929, is a very early example of her mastery of these techniques. Death of Procris is also a very rare example from Jellett's body of work, in that it represents a theme from classical mythology. The story has a number of variations, but the best known version comes from Ovid's Metamorphosis, Book 4, and is essentially a story of unjustified jealousy and its tragic consequences. Jellett's composition here suggests a familiarity with a painting of the same name in the National Gallery of London by Piero di Cosimo. In common with di Cosimo's work, Procris lies flat along the bottom of the composition, with Cephalus kneeling to the left. However, Jellett has managed to change or adapt aspects of their poses, with Cephalus seen here cradling the head of Procris, who appears to lie on her back with one knee raised. The pale figure of Procris and the tanned figure of her husband conforms to older traditions in representation of the genders, and it assists the viewer in their identification and distinction. The background reads as a broad landscape. The forms of the rocks, the sea, the distant land, and the clouds are all suggested rather than detailed. All forms in the composition are distilled and pared back to their essentials, and there's a deceptive simplicity to the lines and shapes in the composition, which are surrounded by wonderful curved lines and geometric designs, all a nod to the Art Deco movement which was taking place at the time. The importance of Mainey Jellett's work continues to be celebrated both in Ireland and abroad. And more recently, since spring of this year, 2013, Sean Kissan of the Irish Museum of Modern Art has curated a major show entitled Analyzing Cubism. And Meinie Gellert is one of the pioneers of Cubism in Ireland and one of the major players in this exhibition, which has travelled, which has been in Dublin and has travelled to the Crawford Gallery in Cork and now to the F.E. McWilliam Gallery in Banbridge. It's very fitting that this beautiful example by Meinie Gellert comes to auction now in the month that this this show Analyzing Cubism finishes. It's a rare early example by Meinie Gellert. It's rare in terms of size, in terms of subject matter, and of course it's presented in its original frame. So it's really an untouched example that has been in private hands and is a rare opportunity for lovers of Gellert's work and people that are interested in the modern art movement in Ireland to come and take a look at this piece, which really is of museum worthy status. As I said, it's coming up as lot 52 in the auction and it's guiding 30 to 50,000 euros.